Alright, I'm Sam, which is short for Samsung.
For obvious reasons, they call me Red.
Alright, where the hell is my cap?
What?
My cap? See my other bud? See the cap? I don't have my other one. Where is it?
Dude, I don't know. Your owner probably lost it, like he always loses you.
Alright, I'll believe you, but if I find out you're lying, it's going down.
Whatever.
Hey guys, I'm Blue.
Hey buddy.
So yesterday, Sam and Red got into a fight about who was going to be my friend, and someone filmed it and put it on Worldstar.
Oh hell no.
It was me. I filmed it. My owner lost me like 6 months ago, so now I just kind of wander around.
So every time there's a new member to the crew, Red always drives him away because he overwhelms them trying to be their friend.
Sam is full of it.
I don't know why they're fighting. I consider them both my friends.
So usually I get put in a pocket for about 3 hours. I'm usually taking a nap, but my owner takes me out and uses me for about 30 minutes. Then I get put away. But after 2 hours, I come out, get used for the rest of the day. My owner sometimes loses me and sometimes loses my cap, but it's okay.
Alright, well honestly, half the time, my owner loses me. He messes me up all the time. Now only one of my headphones works. So honestly, I hate my life.
Well, they call me Blue because I'm a Bluetooth headphone. But my owner is pretty good at taking care of me. Plus, I'm brand new and he's a businessman. So yeah.
Even though everyone in our cast had a little problem, I think everyone's great.
Yeah, even though we have our differences, everyone's great. Except Lo. He sucks.
Everyone's great. Hopefully we stay good friends even after this is over.
I've never seen you before.
It's my first time.
At least you came out. There are tons of kids at school who miss her and loved her, but they never come out. I try and come out here every once in a while, just so I keep her memory fresh. She was so driven and hardworking. She was gonna go to film school, top of her class. She wanted to change the way people saw things. She was gonna do big things. Little did she know, she was already changing things. She was my rock, and it took me forever to get my footing without her there. Hey, I don't think I've ever seen you at school.
We didn't go to school together.
Then how'd you know her?
I didn't really.
Oh, I just assumed. Sorry.
It's okay.
Well, at least you came out here. You know, today's the 1 year anniversary of her death.
Yeah, that's why I'm out here.
So, if you didn't go to the same school, and you didn't know her, why are you here? I don't mean to be rude, I'm just curious.
I saw it happen.
You saw it happen? What happened? Wait! Wait! Please, I need to know what happened. She was my best friend.
It was early in the morning. Really early. Barely light. He couldn't keep the car straight. He must have been really tired. He didn't see her running because he was looking down at his phone. He was going too fast and she must have stopped to tie her shoe and... He got out to check on her, but she was already dead.
She was gonna change the world. She was really gonna make an impact.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
The year 2016 will go down in as one of the most pulverizing years in American political history. You have the feminists be more vocal than ever, while many feel that they're just being overly sensitive and are limiting many's freedom of speech. You got several people who felt that they were being oppressed by the majority, while several people felt the same about the minority. And none of this was helped by the 2016 presidential elections. The loud, extremely opinionated, and extremely politically incorrect Donald Trump ran as the Republican nominee against a feminist, trying to appeal to everyone politically correct Hillary Clinton, who ran as Democrat. Both just as controversial, just as hardworking, and just as disliked, not just by their opponents' voters, but by their own side. The extreme left liberals, especially the feminists, obviously sided with Clinton, despite many Democratic voters thinking Bernie Sanders, the other Democrat runner who lost the nomination, would have been a better president. Many citing only the fact that she's a woman on why they voted for her. Of course, there are many other reasons why one would have voted for Clinton, but that's the reason I saw come up the most among the extreme left. Simply because she's a woman. Not because of anything she said or has done, but because she's a woman. Now, a good parallel would, oddly enough, be the 2016 Ghostbusters reboot, in which many of those same people labeled anyone who disliked the film a misogynist simply because the film starred women. As far as their reaction to Trump goes, obviously, they hated him. He called a ban on Muslims a wall between America and Mexico and called countless women whores. He wasn't going to appeal to anyone who was even remotely easily offended. The extreme right's reactions to both candidates was naturally the exact opposite of the left liberals. They loved Trump mostly because he was successful and hated Clinton because she was a liar. This was all despite the fact that Trump has had several failures, sending into bankruptcy more times than most other billionaires, and that PolitiFacts.com has found that Trump has lied approximately 15% more times than Clinton. And so after over a year of debating and arguing, election night finally came, and despite all odds, Donald J. Trump won the election. Now, it's interesting to note that he only won thanks to the Electoral College, instead of the popular vote. That actually favored Hillary Clinton. So in a way, she should have won the election, but because of an old tradition I still can't understand, Donald Trump will be our next president. The Trump supporters, obviously, rejoiced it while the man himself went on hiring the exact people he said he wouldn't hire as the leaders of the government departments, and calling for safe spaces after the cast of Hamilton expressed their freedom of speech, an act that he and his supporters criticized the liberals for supporting. And, of course, the extreme right followed along. The Clinton supporters rioted in the streets demanding a recount. Most of these riots happening in California, a state that Clinton won, and since you can only demand a recount in the state you reside in, the acts coming from leftists is confusing. Not to mention how Californians have been calling for a recession for the state to become its own country. Considering that this didn't work for Texas, a much larger state, and that they're currently in a drought, makes these demands equally confusing. What I find most interesting is that Trump supporters have told these leftists to accept the results and get over it. Funny, seeing how many of them, including Trump himself, have stated that they won't accept the results if Clinton won. To be fair, they also believe that the election is rigged against them. Except for whenever they're winning. Can you say irony? Now, I'm sure whoever is watching this is either thinking that I'm a Clinton oversensitive supporter or a Trump supporting bigot. Now, I would like to put your mind to rest by saying I'm neither. I'm much more in the middle, leaning towards left. If anything, I voted for Jill Stein. So I'm on neither side. And the reason is because both sides are crazy. Extreme left feminists are too easily offended, and their excuse for voting for Clinton over either Sanders or any third party candidate makes no sense. And the extreme right anti-feminists seem to not understand what they're supporting or how outdated their opinions are. Oh, and their candidates, they're crazy too. They both have insane ideas that at best can't happen or at worst goes against the Constitution in every way. So I'd imagine you asking, how do we fix this? Simple, wait for the next election in 4 years. Trump's ideas are so insane that there's absolutely no way they can possibly happen. The worst that'll happen is that he ruins our branches of government, which is temporary and can be solved by our next president. And when the next election comes around, vote for a third party. The greatest problem with our democracy is that Democrats and Republicans are so at odds that nothing gets done. Third parties don't have to vote for one side, so they get people on either side to agree with them a lot easier than a Democrat or Republican could. And for those who think voting for a third party is like throwing a vote away, if enough people change that mindset, then it can be done. As for which third party to vote for, pick whichever one you agree with most. It doesn't matter, because if you insist on saying either red or blue, nothing will be done. And if something does get done, it'll be for the worse, because they're two extremes. If you're sick of hearing two extremes just yell at each other, then vote for a third party. I don't care which one. Green Party, Libertarian Party, a Spectacular Party, I don't care. As long as it's not Democratic or Republican, because if we stay in a Democratic Republican system, nothing will be done for the better.
But what about the things you don't know?
The top 10 things you didn't know about Star Wars! Number 1!
Did you know that Yoda was almost played by a monkey wearing a mask?
You mean Frank Oz?
Number 2!
Actor Alec Guinness, who played Ben Kenobi, thought of Star Wars as fairy tale rubbish. What does he know, right?
Number 3!
You can see E.T. in the Galactic Center in Revenge of the Sith, man.
Holy crap, are you saying that the universes are connected?
We sure are, man!
Oh my...
Number 4!
There are actually no female fighter pilots in the original trilogy. They were all removed from the final cut of the movie. What the hell?
I can hold it!
Pull up!
No, I'm all right!
Number 5!
Did you know the Return of the Jedi was actually supposed to be called Revenge of the Jedi? But Lucas scrapped that because Jedi do not seek revenge.
Oh my god! 6!
The phrase, "I have a bad feeling about this," is said in every movie.
I have a bad feeling about this. I've got a bad feeling about this.
Oh, I have a bad feeling about this.
Very bad feeling about this.
Oh my god, it is!
Yeah.
Love it!
No one knows. Physical clone trooper outfits made for Attack of the Clones. They are all 100% CGI. So are most of the sets. And the characters.
Special effects are just a tool, a means of telling a story. People have a tendency to confuse them as an end to themselves. A special effect without a story is a pretty boring thing.
Number 8!
Harrison Ford actually asked George Lucas if Han Solo could be killed in the carbonite, but he refused. I guess that's not up to you now, is it, George?
Number 9!
Mark Hamill was in a bad car accident before filming on Empire started. The scene where Luke was attacked by a Wampa was added to explain the scarring on his face. Just scarring in the face? At least it turned out better than Paul Walker.
Number 10! Oh my god!
Return of the Jedi almost ended with Luke taking a dying Vader's helmet and putting it on himself and proclaiming, I am Vader now. That's stupid, right? You know, people used to say no to George Lucas. You can just say no. You can just say no!
I may have gone too far in a few places.
Yeah.
And those are the 10 Star Wars facts you guys didn't know.
You can just say no!
Oh, yeah.
Hi, my name is Carlos, and I have a big problem. I only tell the truth. Oh, look, my favorite fruit. A pineapple.
So why are you so passionate about wine?
You know, it all started in middle school. I had terrible grades. Christmas was coming around. I wasn't gonna get what I wanted. But I told my mom, straight A's. I have straight A's. I got Xbox and anything I wanted. So from right there, I realized, why tell the truth?
So how does this affect your daily life?
In most ways, great, you know. There's only a few little flaws about lying. Not enough for me to change. Like, sometimes when I go to the doctor, I don't tell him what's really wrong with me, which is scary because I could have real problems, but I don't think so. So, and then when I go to the dentist and he tells me things like, do you eat candy and all that stuff, of course I'm gonna say no. Why does he need to know if I eat candy? That's none of his business. Take my paycheck, clean my teeth. Oh yeah, definitely. I'm never gonna stop. I love it. It's my best, it's my favorite thing in the world, and I'm real good at it.
Hi, I'm Victoria, and if I had to pick a hobby of mine that I really like, enjoy, I would have to say photography. I think the thing that I really love about photography is that you can kind of like be yourself and be really creative with everything, you know, because the pictures you take, you're creating, even though it is the camera itself that you're obviously using, it's how you see what you're taking a picture of is what really creates what you want to make of it. Like, for example, like a picture of a tree may be a tree to some people, but it might be something more to you.
I'm Jermara. I love hip-hop. Hip-hop is my life, and I love to rap. It all started when I was like 9 or 7, same thing.
Crap, my friend's right there. Check me out.
What's good? I'm in the hood. About to go eat like I should. Eat lunch, not brunch. No cookie cream or Captain Crunch. Ooh.
One time I was at a funeral and my friend died. Too bad, he owed me $5, so I released a diss track. Come on now. Sometimes it gets out of hand, you know? You know, I rap at the most inappropriate times. I really just try to control myself, and it's just not easy. I'm so sorry, can we?
Hi, my name is Jacque, and I started baking when I was 10. I would say my biggest inspiration would be my mother. Well, she always talked about, like, opening up her own, like, shop that she wanted to be like a family business, you know? And, you know, I decided to keep on with that. You know, the basics, cupcakes, cookies, you know, stuff like that. Flan, I want to make flan. You know, that's something like everybody loves, everybody enjoys, so I want to be able to make something that everybody would enjoy.
understand. I should go on.
Strange voicemail. That's strange.
Damn, I gotta go find him. Cut.
What's wrong, man?
Nothing matters.
How you saying that?
If you saw what I saw, then you would know.
What did you see? Is that a tape?
No. No, you need to see what's on here.
Alright.
I'll just show you. Let's go. Alright. Are you ready?
I guess. You know we gotta show everyone else, right?
I know. Tomorrow we'll upload it, and then after that, it's the end of the line for us.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. My phone's ringing. Someone's trying to get my location. My security app on my phone is telling me this. Did somebody follow us here? You're ready to upload the video. This video both saved and destroyed our lives.
Destroy it. What's all right? Like, what's wrong with the tape? Why can't we're FBI. You cannot destroy it. You understand?
I don't get what's going on.
Do not destroy the tape.
What? We're not trying to destroy it. We need to upload this.
You can't upload it either.
What? Why?
I didn't ask these questions. I just follow rules.
He hasn't even seen the video. I'm just gonna upload it so everybody can see. No, no.
You're not uploading it.
At least watch what's on the tape. Have you even seen it?
No, but it's not my job. My job is to stop you guys.
Whoa. You need to see what's on the tape.
Why?
You need to see it. Listen, if you watch it, we'll give it back to you.
Okay, fine.
You think it's gonna be all right?
I don't know.
Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe for more content. Stay up to date by visiting our website at basicacademy.org or our social media outlets.